this point, we're going to have Bernie cross-examine Eric's stance.
Okay, Eric, can we judge a person's actions to see if they're immoral or not, even if they're the president, the king, or a dictator?
Can we judge a human being's action? Yes, we can.
Okay. Are you sure about that? 100% sure.
I judge other people's morality. Okay. Yes, I do.
So can we judge God's behavior also, as written in the Old Testament?
My question would be, by what standard are you judging it by?
Same standard you judge people by.
I judge by God's standards. So to judge God by God's standards, it'd be inconsistent to say, hey, I'm going to use God's standard to then come back and say, God, you're wrong.
Well, for example, if a guy raped a woman, you would say that's immoral. But if God raped a woman, would that be immoral?
God can't do that, and he wouldn't do that. And yes, that would be immoral.
Okay, so then you can judge God.
That would be immoral. Raping a woman is an immoral act.
Okay, so you can judge God if he were to do that. You don't think he would do it, but if he were to do that, then you could judge God.
Okay.
Right? Okay, good, because that's a point. So now we got established here, we can judge God. So now we just look at what this Yahweh character in the Old Testament do. So in Deuteronomy 22, it talks about if you find a girl who's supposedly not a virgin, like I said, I mean, you can't even tell if a woman for sure whether she's a virgin or not. But if she's not a virgin...
I could, by the way, and mine was. There we go.
Okay. If your wife had a...
Of course.
If the hymen was broken, that does not mean that... number one, they could have sex. Some hymens are flexible, so they could have sex even after penetration. They're not broken. I know, but we're talking about the Bible, too.
I agree. I don't talk about a lot of things that the Bible talks about.
And the other thing is, the hymen could be broken for reasons beyond sex, just exercising or accidents. So it doesn't prove anything. And now God says, hey, if you think your woman is guilty of this, you can kill her.
Is that wrong?
Of course.
On what standard? Who are you? Is that your opinion, or are you applying to a standard?
On consequentialism, on reciprocity.
Could you be wrong about that?
And not only that, but there's no evidence for it.
Could you be wrong about the fact that is wrong of God?
I don't think so. I mean, that's like saying you'd be wrong. I mean, no, I think it's not...
So it's absolutely true.
To kill, even if she was guilty of being not a virgin on a wedding night, I think it's immoral to say kill her. Is that one of your unchanging...
Based on whose standard? All I'm asking, you've got to give me the who says so. Okay. You know, when I'm talking with my son and I say, clean your room, he's like, I don't want to. And I say, buddy, clean your room. And he goes, why? And I say, because I said so.
Okay, so
I'm applying to a standard.
So do you think that's a good moral law that God laid down in Deuteronomy?
I'm not about to. First of all, we are in a totally different time. You confuse several things.
Put yourself in that time.
By reading something from the text that said this applied to Israel. Why doesn't Eric do this?
Thought experiment.
I'm not in Israel. I'm
thought
not
experiment.
Jew.
Go back in that time, that culture, that everything. Is that a moral thing? You said morals don't change.
For example,
culture and time.
One of the things that I'm sure I don't know. Maybe you already knew this. Maybe you didn't. But it's actually the reason when a woman was raped in the Bible. The man who raped her was actually required to marry her is because she couldn't get married back then if that had been the case. He was required to marry her to take care of her because otherwise nobody would take care of her. It was actually morally good thing for that to happen.
That's a different question. I'm talking about killing a woman.
Who?
Killing a woman.
I'll tell you this. Anything that God commands is moral. When God, let's take it to an extreme. What about killing the entire population of the world except for eight people?
My turn to ask questions.
Was that morally right or wrong?
I just wanted to see if we established that you said, I think you can judge the actions of God, the character in the Bible.
Anything that God commands is moral.
And so you think this is a moral command?
If you say it's not, my question is, says who?
I'm asking your opinion. You think it's a moral command.
I think that what God does is moral. Morality comes from God's very character.
So you think that was a good moral thing to do, is to kill a woman who's accused of being not a virgin?
Let me answer this. Is it right for a man to stab a little girl in the chest with a knife?
What does that have to do with the Old Testament passage?
It's going to make perfect sense after you answer the question. Is it right or wrong for a man to stab a little girl in the chest with a knife?
Maybe in self-defense, if there was a different situation.
Let's make a side. stabify the world in the chest, but
I hope the guy was groggy, he was asleep, he woke up and she had a gun to his head, and so he didn't start the business.
It's more relative.
I mean, it's situational.
Okay, so if it was let's make it real easy, the little girl was lying there asleep, is it right for a man to stab a little girl in the chest with a knife?
No.
It's not.
No, it's not.
What if I gave you a little more information? Here's exactly what happens when we talk about the Old Testament. What if I gave you a little more information? What if the little girl's under anesthetic? And it's a world-class surgeon that's going to do heart surgery, and if he doesn't do that, she's going to die.
So like I said, it depends on the situation.
But what you said at first is, you apply to an absolute standard until you got some more information.
Right.
Then you said, yes, that is morally correct. That's the exact same way with
the
Old Testament. You and I don't understand all the things that God was doing back
it's
then.
It's not hard to understand about the situation if she's accused of being a virgin and she
you know what?
Doesn't
those
know
are those are things that are absolutely fabulous questions for a Bible study. But for somebody who denies knowledge, those questions don't even make sense.
Well, there's a lot of people that study moral philosophy, so they think it makes sense. And
if they deny
just,
knowledge, it
just,
doesn't make sense, does it? Can you deny knowledge and then say anything you study actually makes sense? No.
Do you think, for example, if you're the president of the United States, let's say, for example, how much time do I have left? Okay. Let's say, for example, Muslim extremists hijack an airplane and send it to the White House. Would you, if you're the president, would you give the order to shoot it down?
I'll answer the question. I'll back it up. I'll start it off with this. I find it interesting that you are somebody who would agree with cultural relativism, but you would call what they're doing wrong. They believe it's right. What right do we have to stop them? And now this isn't my worldview. This would be consistent with your worldview. What right do you have to stop them from doing what they believe is actually right?
Well, I'm going to find out your answer. Would you give the order to shoot down? With your moral understanding?
For all the Muslims out here,
I don't care if it's a Muslim or a Christian.
I hope that we all repent and trust in Christ.
I don't care who they are. If they're any kind of hijackers with an airliner hijacked and sent to the White House, would you give the order to shoot down? There's 300 people on board.
In a way, what I would do is irrelevant to your act, because what you're asking for is my opinion.
I'm looking for your moral reasoning to see
how
to calculate things.
But if you can't know what truth is, how can you even be looking for what my moral reasoning is if you don't know what is moral?
So the problem is the Bible doesn't say, so you don't know.
Oh, no, I know what I would say. My point is, you're trying to judge me based on an absolute moral standard that you say you don't even have.
Well, I'm trying to figure out what your moral reasoning is, and you don't seem to have an answer for it.
I mean,
for me, it's easy.
The Bible tells us very clearly there are times for justified war. Yes, it is justifiable to stop an attack on you. That is justified war, according to the Scripture. Yes.
Okay, and that's good. Thank you. I'm going to be passing out...